What's going on YouTube and welcome to another video. Just got a package that came in the mail today. Two things about this package. Well, three things about this package. Number one, it is a shoe.
Oh, surprise, I know, it's crazy.
Oh, Corey, you're filled with such lots of surprises. Secondly, I'm not too fond of these shoes. I really don't like the shoes at all. And thirdly, I'm probably gonna end up sending them back to Nike. I'm gonna kinda explain myself as to why I really don't care for this shoe. I got these on the sneakers app. They had released two different pairs of shoes. So last Saturday, they released the Air Fear God Raids in the light bone colorway. They also released the Nike Air Fear God Moccasins. I did not want the moccasins. I wanted the raids. The sneakers app gave me a W, which it kinda did. I got the moccasins instead. You had to act like you were going to purchase a shoe, then you had to wait in line, and then it's really luck of the draw after that. Whoever signs on, should I say whoever, or should I say which bot sign on? Because the bots always get there first. These released last Saturday. They retailed for about $170. I would not get these for resale. I don't even think in the far future that these are even gonna be worth any money. I've seen a lot of comments where people hate whenever I actually bash a shoe. They seem to get kind of mad about it. So let's do it again. Comes in a standard, looks like a Jordan box. You got the pull tab right here. It's this crimson. Whatever with this crimson stuff Nike's doing. I like it. It's a cool color. I like it. With reflective Nike on the box, you can see right there. The glue smell is ridiculous.
Yeah, I don't know.
The Nike Air Fear of God Moccasins. Jerry Lorenzo and his co-created line, Fear of God, started collabing with Nike. As far as the material goes on this shoe, the shoe features a laceless light bone upper colorway with an elastic strap, just like the OBJs I released. It's just a standard Velcro, strap. No shoelaces, again, no shoelaces. As you work your way to the back of the heel, they're calling this a toggle pull lacing system in order to tighten the heel on your foot. Let's not put fancy words on it with a toggle system. This is a strap that you have. This is like a standard pull tab that you have on your windbreaker jacket that you pull on the bottom that actually tightens around your waistband. They're calling it a toggle system. You have this matte black rubber tips on the
toggle system itself.
This has a double stack Nike Zoom Air unit. You can see with the translucent right here on the midsole. That part's cool. It does look like, I would say the first Fear of Gods are more of a high top shoe, and you would consider this more like just a mid. I think how they're marketing it is more of just a lifestyle comfortable shoe that you can just slide on and slide off. On the outer part of the shoe here, you have a button that has a Nike emblem that you pop off. There's not really a whole lot to this shoe. The material is very light. The material also feels cheap in my opinion, but they want it to be light. And as I've talked about in previous videos, we associate light materials with cheap. These did release in selective retail stores and on selective online stores. It was on the sneakers app. That's where I got mine. You can actually get it right now on StockX for around $180, and then you got to pay the $13.95 authentication fee. So $180, $190. Do I think that this shoe will actually go down in value, especially on a place like StockX? I really do. I seriously think you could see this shoe going anywhere down to $140, $150 at some point. What I like about this shoe is the color combination with the particle beige, and you have the light bone, and then you have that pure platinum black right here on the Nike emblem itself. I can find better reasons to spend $180 than on a pair of shoes that I'm not really in love with. I'm gonna try them on though. People say, oh, this isn't dead stock. I get it. I've tried them on, but I'm literally gonna be on carpet. Button this on the side. So it's kind of hard to do with one hand. And you're good. But see what I'm talking about? Like, there's a gap here. Let's see what this does. Toggle pulling system. Yeah, I can't really do it with one hand. Tried on the shoes, warm a little bit. in the house. These are probably one of the most uncomfortable shoes I've ever worn in my entire life. I've worn a lot of shoes. Here's the issue. This toggle system back here, with the lighter materials, you have no heel support. So whenever I have the shoe on and I feel like I just step even at all, this material is so flimsy and loose. It's like there's no support here. My heel felt like it was slipping. The double zoom here, I felt like there was a ton of weight on my heel and everything was just flat. There's no support on this shoe whatsoever. I wouldn't even consider it a lifestyle comfy type shoe. I don't like it at all. I think that this shoe collab should have just stayed on the drawing board. I just don't think it's a very good quality shoe and I don't like the style of it. That's just my opinion. I appreciate you guys so much for watching my video. Thank you again for staying with me and subscribing to all you guys that are subscribed to my channel. If you are new to this channel, please make sure to like and subscribe. Leave me a comment down below. Let me know what you guys think of the shoe. Again, thank you so much for staying with me and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.